नमस्कार एंड वेलकम अगेन टू प्लेनेट टू सोलर एस्ट्रोलॉजी एंड आई एम वेरी श्योर यू ऑल आर लर्निंग फ्रॉम माय वीडियोस एंड यस टुडे आई हैव कम विथ अनदर न्यू टॉपिक विच इज़ कनेक्टेड टू नवमांश कुंडली. सो लास्ट टाइम ऑल्सो आई टॉक्ड अबाउट नवमांश एंड प्रोफेशन ऑफ योर स्पाउस थ्रू D9 and through D10 also. So if you have not seen those videos, I will be putting link in description box. Please watch that video so that things will be more clear to you. Secondly, now the series what I have started, this series will be only connected to Navmansh Kundali. Like previously whatever videos I made, those were also connected to D1 chart. But now I will solely talk about Navmansh Kundali only. It is a second step to study Navmansh Kundali. First step already we discussed multiple sessions. Okay, still too much is remained. So let us see. Sometimes definitely we will carry forward the same thing. Unless and until 7th house is over, we cannot start over other houses in Navmansh. 7th house itself has so much in Navmansh Kundali. Then we will definitely start with other houses also, like your own characteristic. How will be your wealth status, health status, you know, your social status, your overall well-being. Everything through Navmansh we can definitely assess and definitely we can make good predictions out of that. Healthy and strong predictions we can make. So today friends, what I'm going to talk that how you will know that my marital bliss will be, or who are already married, how is the marital bliss for them. So there is a one simple technique I'll be discussing. As you all know, in every marriage, happiness is very much necessary. Unless and until spouses are happy with each other, the marriage will not go. There could be some or other difference of opinion, but that does not mean that marital bliss is not there. Small disputes, quarrels, misunderstandings are always there, and that is a part and parcel of a good relation also, healthy relation also. Only pampering each other is not enough, but pampering each other's emotions, pampering each other's true soul is equally important. By true soul, I remember very soon my new video on how to find your soulmate in Navmansh Kundali is going to come. So for that, stay tuned with my channel. If you have not yet subscribed, do subscribe. And yes, many people write to me in comment box how to contact me for consultation. So please visit my website planet2soul.com, or you can email me at sunilijanipawar@gmail.com to book your consultation. Coming back to Navmansh Kundali, take ascendant lord from your Navmansh, take seventh lord from your Navmansh, see both lords' position in Navmansh Kundali. This will 100% decide how will be your marital bliss. If these planets are malefic in the sense they are strong planets, like your ascendant rising is Mars, say you have Aries ascendant rising in Navmansh Kundali and seventh lord happens to be Venus, so see Mars and Venus. So Venus is a soothing planet, at the same time too much of expectations, and Mars, you know, is a hot and aggressive planet, passionate planet. So if Mars and Venus are going 3-11 to each other, 9-5 to each other, posited together in trine houses, posited together in center houses, then definitely marital bliss or marital happiness or longevity of marriage is good. Specifically for longevity of marriage, even though if malefic planets are there, like, you know, Saturn, Mars, or Saturn and Surya, like if Aquarius is rising or Leo is rising, so this way also you can see. And along with this ascendant and seventh lord, even though they are benefic planets, but if Saturn, Mars, Rahu or Ketu are posited, still we can say that marriage is at least not breaking. Like, marriage will run. Second thing, there won't be like, you know, break or divorce like situation. So marriage will run well. But because of this Rahu, Ketu, or because of Mars, definitely there will be difference of opinion, over domination over each other. But because of the benefic planet and posited in trine houses or 311, definitely there will be highly emotional connectivity between husband and wife. Second thing what you have to see for a good marital bliss, you just see that how your, this is the second technique I am saying, how is your Dharakarak planet and your seventh lord are posited in Navmansh Kundali. See, for example, your Dharakarak planet happens to be moon and your seventh lord happens to be Jupiter. So first thing, both are very good friends. They are happy going together. Second thing, wherever they are posited in a horoscope, they will enhance the fruit of that house. Third thing, Dharakarak and seventh lord are if benefic planets, then also marriage happiness, we can say, is better. How it will be more better? If this Dharakarak and seventh lord are posited again in 9, 5, 3, 11 center houses, specifically in 9th house of horoscope, then definitely good bliss. If both the planets are posited in 12th house of horoscope, and if you are staying abroad or connected to foreign land, then do not worry. Definitely marriage bliss is very, very good in your horoscope. So it is not always that if Mangalya Dosha is there, then marriage bliss will not be there. Navmansh Kundali or Navmansh Kundali will decide how will be your marital bliss. And above that, one very good point or one important secret I am sharing with you all. Moon and Surya, maybe I shared it before also. Moon and Sun are if well aligned with your Dharakaraka planet or seventh lord, like your seventh lord is with moon, or if your Dharakaraka is with moon, then there will be always emotional connectivity between you and your spouse. I am talking here about emotional connectivity. Longevity of marriage, also again Jupiter comes into action. What is the nature of planet? What is the element of planet? What is the characteristic, signification of that planet? Signification of house that planet is posited. All these things also play very, very important role. But the basic thing what you have to see in your Navmansh Kundali is first lord and seventh lord position in D9 only. How they are posited, that will definitely define your marital happiness, marital bliss. And again, your Dharakaraka and seventh lord will decide your marital bliss. That is the second technique. There are thousands of techniques to see in Navamansa Kundali. And definitely, the inner character of your spouse is also described through your Dharakaraka planet in D9. Correct? So you have to see that how this Dharakaraka planet is posited with your ascendant lord also, not only seventh lord. Ascendant lord of Navamansa Kundali is you yourself, rising Navamansa. And Dharakaraka planet, you have to see both the planets in D9, how they both are posited. If they both are 4:10 to each other, that is a Sangharsha Yoga. That means they are going in center to each other. So marriage bliss is there, but there will always be some or other type of disputes or miscommunication or misunderstandings between husband and wife, because Kendra houses are connected to Sangharsha, 4:10. If they are again in a good position, then we can definitely say that marriage will go good. In today's life, friends, marriage is very important, and to get a good partner, caring partner, soothing partner, understanding partner is equally important, mandatory and necessary. So whenever you are matching any horoscopes, if you do not know anything, just go ahead with these 2-3 points I have said. Provided the birth time is given correct and Navamansa rising is correct, then definitely you will find better fruits. If you are not having any correct timing or Navamansa, then just go for moon chart. So this was all about seeing marital happiness in Navamansa Kundali as per Parashara as well as per Jaimini. Very small tip I have tried to share. Hope you will utilize it. My best wishes to all of you. Let me know in comment how it is going. Stay tuned with my channel. As I always say, Sabka Mangal Ho. May all be blessed. Namaste.